We're at Selby Gardens, Spanish Point in Sarasota. This is Jennifer and my silver wedding anniversary today.
Yeah, hopefully the bees don't land on us.
They invited themselves in.
Well, yeah, this is a good place for them to be.
Yeah. Ones right there are giant swallowtails.
This is the Guptill House, built on one of the Mindens.
This was built in 1900. It took 10 years, hand-built. Hand-carved staircase. Using curly pine. Used up until 1920. This is the only pioneer house, hand-built, that is still remaining.
So, tell me about this dress.
This is a dress inspired by Meg from Hercules. Yes, it's not exact, but I found it for $15 at a Freestyle in Folsom, so I felt pretty good about it. I didn't get a chance to wear it at Disney though. One, because it was a little too hot. Two, because I felt like I couldn't really run in this and like, it's a little long. And three, it just didn't really feel like a good outfit compared to my other shorts and tank top outfits. So we're wearing it here.
So we're in Sarasota at the Ringling Museum. And behind us is one of the mansions they built. It's supposed to be a Venetian Gothic palace.
We're at the Everglades National Park, and this is Shark Valley. An alligator surfaced over there.
It's a good size, maybe 6 feet.
You see him? There's got to be a mama gator suit close.
That was a baby gator. Well,
I'm telling you that there's got to be a mama gator close by.
In between underestimated and overexpected, who I was and who I'm gonna be.
Sunset of her 40s. We're at Key West.
We're hoping this is my beginning of my second half of my life tomorrow.
We're at Sunset Key for Jennifer's birthday for breakfast. Happy birthday, Jen.
Half a century.
Do they smell good, Jennifer?
Oh, I have no idea. Nope. Normal, no smell.
Just pretty, huh?
Oh, beautiful.
Look at this incredible thing. Smells like star jasmine. It's got big fruit on it too. This is the little White House. Harry Truman stayed here. Eisenhower, Roosevelt, even Clinton for a period. And a few others. And Edison was here for 6 months during First World War and invented 41 new wartime weapons. This is Fort Jefferson in the Dry Tortugas on Garden Key. This right here was built by the Navy to store gunpowder for the ships. Look at the thick walls of the second floor. The biggest cannon was intended to be up here.
This is one of the huge 25-ton cannons. Fired a 450-pound shot. Enormous muzzle.
This cannon still has its rails for rotating. The walls here are just so remarkably thick, yet this 8-foot thick outer wall was nowhere near enough for when they got rifled pointed projectiles.
Mickey's standing by one of the cisterns. So every other pillar in this has a cistern where they would have the water from the third floor flow down through the sand, down into here, and then into the cistern down there.
So after the War of 1812, where the British came and burnt down the US capital, they built forts up and down the coast. And after they built Fort Zachary at the end of Key West, they built this place, West Martello. There was also East Martello, and this is now a botanical garden. This is a natural butterfly garden. No cage or anything keeping them in. Just attracted by all the flowers here.
When the people of town realized this fort was going to be abandoned, they used this as a brick-free shopping center.
Brickyard. Where you don't make any bricks. Yeah. You just take them.
We're at the Fort Zachary Chamber, and this is one of the cannons they use.
How big is it?
It's about 10 inch.
You guys, show me how big 10 inches is for these cannons. Pretty big, huh? Imagine having a rifle shot that size coming at you. You guys crab spotting?
Crab hole spotting. Is the largest hole. Tried to look impressed,
not very convincing. We're at Robbie's Marina.
Look at that guy.
We rented a boat today and we're at Hen and Chicken Reef. I don't see any hens or any chickens. I guess it's the chicken of the sea, right?
And a stingray!
How big was it?
Like 8 foot long, including the tail.
Yeah, about 4 foot for the body.
Yeah.
And 5 to 6 foot wide.
Yeah.
Really impressive. Black and white, like a leopard print. We are at the sandbar. Yeah, Jennifer's drifting into the boat.
Almost ran out of sunscreen. Good thing it's our last day though.
Good last day, huh?
It is a good last day.
There he is.
No one else did the first mate. Round of applause.
Round of applause.
Yay, for the first mate.
Oh, yeah. I thought we were not clapping.
Yeah, first with that mate. Much noise there.